Now let us know about waves. So this is the water tank. This is calm water surface. When this surface is disturbed by dropping a pebble, particles of the medium vibrate. These vibrations travel in all directions and form a ring-like pattern. It is like this. Look here. Here there is an impact. These rings, this ring-like pattern is known as waves. Once again, look here. These are the waves. Consider a thread. It is held with one hand. When this one end of the thread is disturbed, it is like this. The disturbance propagates along the thread like this. So here, this ups and downs known as waves. This up is crest and this down is trough. So look at this crest. So it appears the crest or trough carries this thread, but these waves or crest and trough cannot carry the medium. So if they were carrying the medium, the thread would have detached from the hand. Now let us assume the thread in the form of large number of molecules, because any substance is made up of large number of molecules. Similarly, the thread is made up of large number of molecules like this. And between any two particles, there is a force of attraction which is called intermolecular force of attraction. It is just like a spring. If one of the particles is disturbed, that disturbs the second one, that disturbs the third one, like this. Look here, when this one is disturbed, that disturbance propagates like this. So this is nothing but wave. This is how wave is set up in the medium. Let us see it in slow motion. If first particle is disturbed, the force of attraction between these two particles is like a spring which stretches and it pulls the second particle. So the second particle pulls the third particle. Third particle pulls the fourth one. Fourth one disturbs the fifth one. Like this, disturbance propagates along the line and in a medium. So like this, a wave is propagating like this. And here this is crest and this is trough. If we observe the crests, it appears these crests carry the particles of the medium, but it is not happening so. Take this reference line and place it on the red particle. Look here. This particle is not moving along with the wave, but it is vibrating where it is, about its mean position. Not only this red particle, you place it in on any other particle. They are vibrating about their mean positions. So from this we can understand that waves do not carry medium, particles of the medium along with them. And this is how a wave is generated. Of course, these are mechanical waves. Because of their elastic property, waves are set up in the medium. So therefore they are also called elastic waves. But light is electromagnetic wave. So to understand very important phenomena, principle of superposition, let us consider a crest. So look here, this is the crest. Let me place this reference line on this red particle. Let us see what happens when this crest reaches this red particle. Look here, this crest pulls the particle up and allows it down. So now let us see it in slow motion. Let me place it on this blue particle. Let us see what happens. So look here, as the crest reaches, it pulls the particle up and it allows it to its mean position like this. So the job of crest is pulling the particle in one direction, and it allows the same particle to go to its mean position. So now let us consider a trough. Look here, this is the trough. And now let me place this one somewhere here and let us see it in slow motion. Look here, the trough reaches the red particle. What happens? It pulls the red particle downwards and allow it to go to its mean position like this. So wherever the trough goes, particles are pulled down like this. From this we can understand crest pulls the particles of the medium in one direction, trough pulls the particles of the medium in the opposite direction. By knowing this, now let us discuss the important phenomena, principle of superposition. Principle of superposition. Consider a crest. It is represented by y1. y1 is displacement of the particle due to this crest, and y2 represents the another crest. So it is also displacement of the particle due to this crest. When these two crests or waves meet at a common region, for example like this, this is known as superposition. Where they superpose, we get a single wave. This is known as resultant wave. So this is due to superposition of these two waves. The superposition takes place where the two waves superpose, and these two, after superposition, they move in their respective directions. Now let us consider one crest and other trough. As they superpose, let us see what happens. Look here. So here what has happened, the crest pulled the particle up and trough pulled the particle down, but the pulling up crest is greater than pulling up trough, therefore we get a resultant trough like this. Here it is y is equal to y1 plus y2. Once again let me repeat it. So they are moving like this, and look here, they are moving in their respective directions. Crest and trough, they give superposition. Look here, let the height of this one be, that is amplitude of this one be 2 cm, amplitude of this one be 4 cm. At this point they meet. Look here, now it is 6 cm, because one crest pulls the particle 4 cm, another crest pulls the particle to the 2 cm. 2 plus 4, it has become 4. This is the resultant. And when opposite, that is opposite superposition, crest and trough superposed. Look here, the crest has pulled a particle to 4 cm, at the same time trough pulled to the 2 cm. 4 minus 2, it is 2. Therefore, resultant pulling is 2 cm. Here it is y is equal to y1 minus y2. This is the principle of superposition. From principle of superposition, we get y is equal to y1 plus or minus y2. If constructive, it is plus. If it is destructive, it will be y minus y2. So now let us discuss the interference. This is the source of light. According to Huygens' wave theory, the source of light is source of vibration of ether particles. Ether particles are the hypothetical particles present everywhere in the universe. This source vibrate ether particles. Just like sound waves vibrate air particles, this source of light vibrate ether particles. And this vibration sets up a wave in the medium. Therefore, we assume the source of light which emit waves like this. So these are the light waves. And here, look here, these are the crests. The particles on these crests are in the same phase. When all these particles are taken or considered or enveloped, we get a surface. So this surface is known as wave front. This is crest wave front. And here, look here, these are the troughs. Consider particles on the troughs and join all of them, and this line or this surface which contain crest points, look here, these are trough points. This is known as trough wave front. Like this, this is the crest wave front and this is the trough wave front. So like this we can imagine a source of light in the form of the source which emits crest trough like this. So this is source of light. Light is emitted from the source in the form of wave fronts, crest wave front, trough wave front, crest wave front, like this. So we know a point source emits a spherical wave front. Look here, this is spherical wave front, At very large distance, if you consider a portion, this portion may be plane. Therefore, this is plane wavefront. Wavefront is spherical near the source, but it is plane at very large distance. Look here, like this.